questions at the outset,
I plead the indulgence, rather I demand appropriate time to place the issues before you. Because I believe, among my colleagues over here, I have been working among the labor front for the last 50 years. As a worker started in an industry, so I know the ins and outs, how a production system works, how a factory works, and how workers are being treated. I rise to oppose this bill. Presently under consideration. I oppose not only because the proposed amendment enhanced permissibility limit of overtime hours from existing 50 hours per quarter to finally 125 hours per quarter. Which is not only because I oppose, not only because it is injurious to the interest of the workers. Extra earning after 8 hours hard work, and if most of the places it is practically not 8 hours, it is much more. It is not at all in the interest of the workers, not only those who have won jobs, but also several thousands of unemployed youth who are aspiring for jobs. Expanding the overtime limit, permissibility limit, by every hour, you are depriving a big chunk of unemployed workforce aspiring to have their place in the world of work. Sir, I also oppose this bill, owing to, forgive me for using the word, for a kind of bungling that has been indulged in over the amendment of this Factories Act. The present government has already introduced a bill, Factories Amendment Bill 2014. The envisaging, I can mention only the substantive change in that bill. Number one, enhancing the threshold level of employment in order to push out more than 70% of the factory workforce out of the purview of the coverage of the Act. Number two, substantive change, increasing the permissible limit of overtime as is being dealt in the present bill. Number three, increasing the spread over period. Out of 8 hours work, earlier spread over was 10.5 hours, now it has been made 12 hours. For doing 8 hour work, a worker has to be retained in his workplace for up to 12 hours. That was the provision. These are the three substantive changes which has been aimed by the Factory Amendment Bill 2014. The Labour Standing Committee took up that issue. They scrutinized the bill. And finally, unanimously rejected all these three substantive changes. But unfortunately, as being a trade union, we are very frequently in communication with the Labour Ministry. In a communication by the Labour Ministry, we find they have written that Labour Standing Committee recommended, okayed most of the changes in the bill. That's a falsehood. Better not to indulge in that. But the fact remains, basic fact remains, that the issue we are now dealing now, the increase of the permissibility limit of overtime from 50 hours per quarter to finally to 125 hours. This issue was also dealt by the Standing Committee, Parliamentary Standing Committee, and also unanimously rejected. They recommended that this is superfluous in view of the technological upgradation in the production system. It is superfluous. And that needs to be reconsidered also in view of the impact of this change on the employment generation. That needs to be reconsidered, that needs to be revisited. But despite such unanimous recommendation of the Parliamentary Standing Committee, without considering anything, the same bill has been put. We have proofs before us. And I don't understand. When your factory amendment bill 2014 is alive, the Parliamentary Standing Committee has given its recommendation on the same. Keeping that bill alive, why a particular issue has been dragged against that and you present another factory amendment bill 2016 year? What is the reason, precisely the logic behind this kind of a bungling? I must say, this reflects the legislative impropriety of the highest order, if not legislative corruption. This is not the way, and if this kind of thing is indulged in, I think what goes at stake, government and opposition, that will always be there. But what is at stake, please? Please. No, that's not the point. That's why I wanted him not to be there. That's why I wanted him not to be there. Anyway,
I am doing my
that's
duty.
Why I wanted, sir, please, don't disturb. Don't disturb my flow, please.
I am doing my duty. He's doing his duty.
What I am telling, that why do you bring out that particular thing? The bill is still alive in the parliament. What makes you to bring it out? And what is at stake is the credibility, trustworthiness. We may fight with one another about the difference of policy or the difference of approach. But by this exercise, what the government has put in stake is the credibility and trustworthiness that is dangerous for our system of democratic action. Please refrain from this. Secondly, sir, what is the reality at the workplaces today? I'll request my friends and also Honorable Minister to roam around Delhi and the adjoining NCR areas in Ghaziabad, in Faridabad, in Haryana, in Gurgaon, in Dharuhera. Please, 12 hours is the order of the day work. In most of the private factories, and in 80% of them, they don't get any extra remuneration, a height of illegality. And in some places, they get some remuneration, but not on the double the rate of wages as per the Factories Act. So already a ocean of illegality is raining on your empire. Instead of addressing that, it is not that you are not knowing this. Again and again, I am a trade union official. At every occasion, we are putting before you this reality. Instead of addressing that, this ocean of illegality is being sought to be utilized, sought to be legalized by your legislative initiative taken in this. Is that the purpose of any legislative initiative? Well, you cannot catch hold of the offenders. You cannot tackle them. So better legalize the crime that is going on. Is that the approach of any legislative initiative? It is very clear that you are not moving. The Labour Ministry name, please, after the name of Labour. You are not working for Labour. You are not working for Labour. What has been demonstrated is the shameless desperation to serve the employers' class in their obsession for ensuring ease of doing business, the ease of survival of the workers, ease of ensuring survival of the workers, the laboring community, is not in your priority because they are not donors. They are not donors. They are faceless voters. That is the tragedy. The working people of the country, who are actually producing your GDP, who are actually delivering revenue to your exchequer, who are actually generating profit for the employers, on a bunch of currency note in a factory shed, value cannot be generated, value cannot be added, and value addition is the essential essence of production, which generates wealth for the nation also. It is because of the workers that they do not deserve this treatment. Sir, what practically we are going to gain out of this? Have you gone into this thing? As per the development of the technology, it has arrived in such a, reached a, such a stage. Even 15 years back, what can be produced in 8 hours can be produced in 1 hour now. In some places, it is half an hour. Do we read this situation? Rather, the time present is the time in view of tremendous improvement, tremendous increase in the productivity of the labor out of the technological, because of the technological development, that ordered need of the hour is to reduce working hour. Instead of 3 shifts, there should be 4 shift operation, 6 hours working. That is the need of the hour. Not enhancing the overtime, not enhancing the permissibility limit of overtime, not taking initiative to legalize the illegality of 12 hours work in the workplace, in the entire world of work. That's not the need of the hour. That is the need of the hour, particularly when unemployment is expanding like a cancer in our society, putting into serious danger that social fabric of peace and tranquility.
Please conclude.
I'm just going to conclude. Sir, what is the situation? Sir, so far as the GDP is concerned, it is increasing. You are claiming. You are claiming, we are accepting. GDP is increasing. But is it generating employment? Last 3 years, what is the employment generation? Your own data says, in 15-16, in the 8 most labor-intensive sector, employment generation was only 1,15,000. And 16-17, as per the reply given by Honorable Labor Minister in this House, in 16-17, out of these 8 employment-intensive sector, in 4 sector, net decline in the employment is to the tune of...
Please conclude. Please conclude.
Just concluding, sir. It is to the tune of 18,000 job loss. In such a situation, this indulgence to increase in overtime limit is just not permissible. So, in such a situation of extreme low employment elasticity scenario, any proposition for promoting more overtime work is a crime proposed to be committed against the millions of young, energetic job seekers in the country.
Yes,
let us do such crime. And in that direction, I moved certain amendments in the bill, and I plead your, crave your indulgence that kindly these amendments be accepted. That is, I pray to you. With this submission, I conclude.
Thank you for your hearing. Thank you.